Hey folks, what's up? Jeremy Schaefer here. Today I'm going to show you how to fold an ordinary 6-inch square of origami paper into your very own 3D seamless tombstone. And it can even stand. And it's an action model. Turn it over and it's a mouth. And it grinds its teeth. And it can even talk. And you can round the edges so that it looks more like a round tombstone. And I'll show you how to do that. Want to learn how to fold it? Ready, set, here it goes. All right, so this model is folded from a single 6-inch square of kami, no cuts, but in order to make it seamless, which means that there's no creases on any of the sides, we're going to use a second sheet of paper as a stencil. So you need two squares of exactly the same size. And if you want, you can use a couple of ordinary sheets of printer paper cut square. And there's a pretty easy way of cutting them square. What you do is you take one of the papers and you rotate it 90 degrees. And then you line up the corners here and the edges. Make it align perfectly. And now fold this edge right over this edge. And crease sharply. And now fold this edge over this edge. You can also align it with the bottom edge. And now pull them apart and unfold. And now you just need to cut off this extra strip right here. And you can either do that with scissors, like that, or you can tear it off by making the crease really sharp and reversing it once or twice, and then placing it down so that it's like a ridge, and make a little tear at the top right here. And now pull apart your two hands and it'll tear all the way down like that. And here you have your two squares, but I'm going to use 2 6-inch squares of kami. All right, so let's begin with the stencil. So this is gonna be my stencil. So turn over, white side up, and fold in half. And unfold, and turn over, and let's fold this edge to the crease. And rotate 180 degrees. And let's fold this edge to the top. And let's turn over top to bottom, and let's fold this edge to the crease. And crease sharply, and now unfold, and let's fold this edge up on this crease. And let's rotate 180 degrees, and we are done with the stencil. So get your other sheet of paper, and let's turn it over so it's white side up. And what you want to do is you want to slip it underneath this flap, and slide it all the way to the back, and you want to line up these edges and make sure that it's perfectly straight. And now hold it down here so that it doesn't slip out. And now let's fold this edge to this edge and make sure that it lines up perfectly, and make the fold, and fold sharply. And now unfold and pull it out, and let's rotate it 180 degrees and slip it back into the pocket all the way to the back and line up the edges. And now let's, once again, let's fold this edge to this edge. And crease sharply, and unfold. And now let's rotate 90 degrees, and let's stick it back in. And this time we're going to do the same thing, but we're just going to make a really small crease mark between these two creases. So bring the flap up and now just press right here. Try not to extend outside of these creases, just like that, and unfold and pull it out and rotate it 180 degrees and put it back in. And once again, let's bring the flap up, make the edges touch, and put a little crease mark right there in the middle. And now unfold, and now let's pull it out and unfold. And now let's refold the stencil on the third crease. So fold down, you should have three units. One, two, three. And put your square back into the stencil and stick it all the way to the back again. And let's do the same thing. We're going to fold the flap up so that it touches, and we're just going to make a short crease mark right between the two creases. Like that, and unfold and pull it out and rotate it 180 degrees and stick it all the way to the back. And one last time, let's fold the flap up, make the edges touch, and make your short little crease. And unfold, and we are done with the stencil, so you can get rid of that or keep it for your next one if you want to make another one. All right, so now what we're going to do is fold diagonally in half, but we don't want to make creases on the middle square. So let's turn over and try to make the diagonal as a mountain fold. So hold it like this, and we're just going to fold right through this corner. So bring these two edges together, make them align, and fold right through the corner, and make this fold go right to the creases, right there. Okay? And crease it sharply, and unfold. And now we have to do that three more times. So let's do this corner. So hold it up and let's make the mountain fold. Bring these two edges together and pinch right on the corner and make sure that the edges align and fold it all the way to this square, to the creases. Okay, crease it sharply and unfold. And we have two more to go. Let's do this corner. And unfold, and one more corner. Okay, and unfold. Ooh, that looks like a pyramid of some sort. Okay, now let's fold this edge to this crease. So just hold it in the air, and with your finger behind to give support, just fold this edge to the crease. And starting with this point right here, make sure that it comes to a clean point, like that. And now just make the edge align with the crease all the way down. Now turn it over and let's make this fold really sharp. And you should do that against the table, because that way you won't end up with a crease on this paper. So there it is. And turn back over. And now we have to do it on the other three sides. So let's fold this edge to this crease. So let's rotate and make sure that it comes to a point right here. Like that. Okay, and turn over and use the table to make the fold really sharp. Okay, and now let's do the same thing on the other side. So rotate and turn over, and let's fold this edge to the crease. And crease it sharply. And turn back over. And let's fold this edge to the crease. And turn over and crease it sharply. Okay, and now let's rotate and let's fold this flap down like this, and let's fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with this crease and these edges also align, just like that. And you can fold the tippy corner in a little bit so that it doesn't cross the line. Okay, and now let's fold this flap over like this. And let's fold this flap up right on this point so that this edge aligns with this crease. Okay, and you can fold the tippy corner just a tiny bit if you want. Okay, and now let's rotate and do the same thing on this side. So fold the flap over and fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with this crease. Fold the tip over and fold this flap to the right and fold this up so that this edge aligns with this crease. And fold the corner. Okay, and now let's turn over and just try to shape it so that it looks nice, right on all four of these edges. Okay, and so we just turned the corner, and now we're going to turn this corner right here where this where there's a crease right here. You can't really see it, but it's there. So let's try to make that crease. Just pinch it very carefully so that you can actually see it. Pinch right along the existing crease. And now we're going to make a fold that originates right at this point, and it goes straight to the left and is perpendicular to this edge. So here we go. So make your little fold starting right here. And in order for it to be perpendicular, you have to align these edges. So it's just like that. Okay. And let's do the same thing on this side. So make a little crease that originates here, and now line the edges up and make the fold. Okay, and now let's bring this edge to this edge. And when you do this, you can let this corner just kind of swing out like that. You don't need to fold the corner, just let it swing out. Okay, and when you do this, make sure that it comes to a very nice point here. So you want to use your finger inside to provide support. Like that. And let's do the same thing on this side right here. So we're going to fold this edge to here and let this flap swing out. Make sure it comes to a really nice point right here. And there it is. Okay, now we just need to repeat on this side, and then we're almost done. So let's form a pinch right on the existing crease. It's right there. And now we're going to make a fold from this point to the edge. So make your little pinch mark and now align these edges and make the fold. And let's do the same thing on this side. So make a pinch mark right at this point. And align these edges and make the fold. Okay, and now let's fold this edge to here, and this flap can just swing out. Okay, and let's do the same thing over here. So let's fold this edge to here. Okay, and the last step is just to fold these two flaps inside. And we have a crease right here to fold on. So just fold right on this horizontal crease. And it helps if you hold it tightly. That. And let's do the same thing on this flap. So turn over and let's fold this in right on this crease. We're just folding between this point and this point, mountain folding. And there it is. And you can fold these little teeth back out. it's like that. And to make it grind, you just swivel back and forth like that. And here is your tombstone, or somebody's tombstone. So there it is, and it stands, and it maybe rolls, I don't know. Ooh, that's pretty cool. Let's give it a little push. Ooh, yeah. It is an acrobatic model. So yeah, well, there's a nice model for Halloween or for any special occasion. If your pet or somebody passed away, then this is a good way to commemorate him or her. And yeah. Oh, and I almost forgot. You want to see how to fold it round. I really like it more not round, but okay. If you want to fold it round, what you do is you just put your finger in and just press on these points. You want to try to round it. But it's not going to be quite as seamless. It'll be a little bit more sculpted looking, which is, I guess, okay. More organic. And just press on these points. You just want to sculpt it to taste. And same thing on the other side. And now it is round. And make sure that the teeth still work. Yep. And there it is. I think it's a little bit uglier like this, but I guess tombstone doesn't need to be so beautiful. Anyway, there it is. All right, let's see if it works. Nope, it no longer works. So yeah, I like it better like this, but whatever. All right, have a happy Halloween, or whatever other day of the year it is. Bye-bye.